find out.
But if you break your neck, you won't be able to marry me.
I'm not going to marry you anyway, Tom. Not you, not anyone, not ever.
You'll be able to see me score a winning goal in the cup final then.
That's even less likely. Now just get out of the way. I'm going to close my eyes, count to 20 and jump.
Where is it?
Where's what?
My sister.
I wouldn't stand there if I were you.
This is my garden. I'll stand where I want. All right.
All right. Don't say I didn't warn you.
18, 19, 20. Geronimo!
You animal, you did that deliberately.
If I'd done it deliberately, I would have made sure you'd stay down.
Look at the state of me.
Not a pretty sight, but then it never is.
Scumbag, I hate you.
Can you tell her to stop eating like a pig?
Pigs are clean animals, intelligent too. Not like some.
Harmony, eat with more finesse. All that scoffing and slurping puts my nerves on edge.
Finished anyway. Can I have a pet?
No, darling. We've been through this so many times.
Well, let's go through it again. Can I have a pet?
No. Tell her, Arthur. Arthur.
What?
Tell her.
Tell her what, dear?
You can't have a pet.
You can't have a pet.
See?
Why not?
Because I just said so.
But why not?
Because pets are all hairy and flea-ridden.
Snakes aren't hairy. Crocodiles aren't hairy. Armadillos aren't
Harmony,
hairy.
That's enough.
Lizards aren't hairy.
Harmony.
Newts aren't
Harmony,
hairy.
I know.
Yes, shut up. Can I leave the table? Thanks.
Oh, Harmony.
What?
Ginger's coming tomorrow to stay for a while.
Ginger's coming here?
Yes.
How long is he staying for?
Oh, a few days perhaps. I'm not sure.
Uncle Ginger, I wish he'd already arrived.
Harmony!
Uncle Ginger!
Hey!
Where have you been? How long can you stay?
As long as a piece of string. A few days. Good to see you, miss. Mwah.
Crikey! What you got in here? Cannonballs?
Elephant droppings. Take be careful. They're full of valuable information.
Here. What about my fare?
Oh, yes, of course. Excuse me. Here. Keep the change.
What's this?
Wear it around your neck. The Ashinagos make them from the teeth of their dead ancestors. Only a great warrior who will become a god is allowed to wear one.
Oh, nice.
And where's your mother?
She is in bed.
Is she sick?
Only of me. Come on.
Morning, Olive. Very good, Harmony. The Bengal tiger. Excellent. So that's what I did. I stood my ground. And I growled back at him. He moved towards me, and I moved towards him.
Suppose the neighbour's here.
And then?
And then what?
We were but a handshake away. I could feel his hot, fetid breath on my face. I could see the saliva drooling down his teeth, and the cold, mean, hungry look in his eyes. I put my hand behind his ear.
And then what?
I pulled out a box of Swiss chocolates for you.
Ginger, they're my favourites. Wish I could do that.
Wish, wish, wish. Very good. It's very good, Harmony. Still no luck with getting a pet yet, then?
No. The only way I'll get a pet is by magic.
What do you mean, like this?
Cool! I wish you could magic me a pet.
Well, you might just have to do that for yourself. You do a lot of wishing, don't you?
Yeah, but they never seem to come true.
Sometimes wishes take a while and need a bit of a push. But for now, as your mother has taken to her bed, I think you and I should prepare supper.
Oh. Yes. I am sorry you had to prepare the meal.
That's a pleasure, Arthur.
It was lovely. The soup was so sophisticated. What was it?
Nettles.
Stinging nettles.
From the back garden, where the cats do their business.
Yes, yes, Harmony. I'm sure you're used to roughing it, Ginger, living off the land.
I learned to make these from an old bushranger. Of course, to make them properly, you need a few witchetty grubs instead of these caterpillars.
Caterpillars?
Yes, fat ones with herpes.
Excuse me, I need to go to the bathroom.
And where will your travels take you next, Ginger?
To find something.
What?
A giant. He's known by many names. Shukpa, Bigfoot, the Meti. You probably know of him as the Yeti.
Cool. Can I go with you? I wouldn't be any trouble.
Trouble's your middle name, Harmony. Go and find your mother. Ask her if her nerves are up to a bowl of soup. And don't mention nettles.
Okay.
Wow. I wish I could do that.
Teach you the next time I'm here. I'm leaving tomorrow. If I go now, I'll miss the monsoons.
I'll miss you.
Oh, Ginger, it's extraordinary.
It's been wonderful seeing you, Ginger. I don't wish you'd stop all this gallivanting, though. It can't be good for you. No wonder you never married. Why don't you come and live near us? You could open a sweet shop or something.
Perhaps one day I will.
Oh, Ginger.
But for now, the Yeti.
Goodbye, Virginia.
Take care.
There you are. Here. That's for you. Very special delivery.
Thank you, Uncle Ginger.
Uncle Ginger bought it for me. It must have cost at least £50. What did you get? Give it to me!
Get off, you grubby!
Give it to me!
Sorry!
Have a nice day, girls. If you should murder each other while I'm out, ask your mother to telephone me at the golf club.
Still, 50 pence is a lot for a little kid like you.
Go drown yourself, Bucket!
Come on, Harm. Why do you keep looking at it?
Because it's special.
How?
These secret instructions came with it.
Do you understand them?
Not yet.
Well, that's no good then, is it? Might as well spend the money.
Oh, shut up, Tom, and listen. You and I do share a year, you will want to keep me near. What do you think that means?
I don't know.
Of course, if you had a brain, it might help. Mm. I'm 12 and Uncle Ginger must be at least 40. So how do we share a year?
Can't be him then. Who does Harmony share a year with, O mighty genie of the coin? Nope, nothing. Just says 1982.
1982! That's the year I was born. I share a year with the coin. See, I told you it was special. What else?
bark with the birds, and I'm to be found in my hiding place high above the ground.
Huh? You have to look for something high up.
Oh, brilliant.
But where? The balcony! There's no dogs, but there's a pigeon. Mum's up there. We'll have to do it the hard way.
If you kill yourself, I'll never talk to you again. I wanted to marry you.
Obviously. Now just shut up and hold the ladder steady.
Yes, I know. Yes. Or tell the vicar I'll run the bric-a-brac store. Of course. And I'll bring some soft toys as well. Yeah. Mm. Harmony? Melody? Melody?
Can't see any messages. Dad's old golfing hat. I remember this doll, it was Melody's. I pinched it and threw it up here. I told her the fairies had taken it away and executed it. Dead funny, she cried for days.
I'm going to murder you!
Of course, tree bark, not dog bark.
Please, I feel a migraine coming on.
I'm going to tell Dad about you. I'm going to bring back capital punishment.
Beware of wishing for your heart's desire. If it's out of the frying pan, then it's into the fire.
What else does it say?
Royal, not Roman, straight, not snub. Ten's all you've got, and there's the rub.
What's we to do with the coin? Queen. The queen is royal!
Yeah, but what does straight not snub mean?
To know. Maybe the queen knows.
Oh, yeah. I'll just go and ring her, shall I? Wait a minute. What did you say?
Nothing. I just said maybe the queen knows.
The queen knows. Her nose, get it?
No.
Straight, not snub. And the queen's got a straight nose. And there's the rub. And I rub her nose on the coin, like Aladdin rubbing the lamp.
Cool! Go on then, try it.
I wish for an animal of my very own.
Don't seem to be many pets around here yet.
Give it time.
See you tomorrow.
How does it work?
What is a wish, Harmony?
It's when you want something.
And when you believe in you have.
When you believe it can happen.
Thank you.
help in the kitchen. Go and tell Harmony I want her too.
It worked. I wish it really worked. Thank you, Uncle Ginger. You're beautiful, and you're definitely a girl.
I'll call you Anita. There's a problem, though.
If my family find out about you, they'll... get rid of
me. Mum wants you.
What's the matter? Even you don't always look this out to lunch.
Okay, now no messing about. You can see her. I mean, really.
What?
Just tell me what I've got in my arms.
A 6-foot grenadier. A penguin. A lump of cheese.
You're not kidding, are you?
There is something seriously wrong with you.
More to you than meets my eye.
She's not clever enough to pretend. She really couldn't see you.
Perhaps I'm the only one who can.
Sorting through some jumble for the girl guides. You know, I'd really like you to join the guides. You could wear that nice uniform and sing songs.
No way. I wouldn't mind the SAS.
Oh, Harmony, what are you doing?
You can't see her, can you?
See whom?
Yes, it worked. The power of the Queen's nose is beyond belief.
Harmony, don't go completely mad. I don't think I could stand it.
Can I have a raw carrot?
Yes, of course. Oh, and I want you to go to the market for me. I need some onions. Here's a pound. But she hates vegetables.
Some of us want to have good complexions and not end up with spotty, blotchy faces and rancid breath.
Well, it's a bit late in your case to worry about it then, isn't it?
Mum, tell her to try and be a bit more sophisticated.
You asked me for a carrot today, Harmony, so you must like healthy food. Please don't antagonise your sister. Try and be a bit different.
I don't want to be different. I want to be like I am.
What you are is a problem.
Couldn't we trade her in for something better mannered, like a chimpanzee?
Chimps are intelligent, so you wouldn't understand what I was saying.
Please, Harmony. Anyway, Melody is right. Fruit is good for you, isn't it, Arthur?
Mm.
Arthur?
What?
Fruit.
Yes, indeed. It is fruit. Once again, your powers of observation have pushed forward the frontiers of human knowledge. Grief, Harmony, you ate that quickly.
Harmony, manners, little barbarian.
Night, Anita. Night, Uncle Ginger. This is my latest number. It's called Parker Family Blues.
Thank you.
Anita? Anita? Dad said you couldn't have any pets.
You can see her then.
Well, of course I can see her, you fool. Melody, just don't tell Mum and Dad.
You must be joking, I...
My top! I hate you, you little scrag.
Anita didn't mean it. She just doesn't know the rules.
Yeah, but you do. I'm gonna get you for this. And when I tell Mum and Dad about my top and that rodent, they'll ground you for a month. No pocket money until the new top is paid for. And that thing will go too.
Rabbit, you know the rule about pets. I just cannot bear the thought of something else running around this house, especially while you're on holiday.
I told you so. She just sort of appeared.
And she'll just have to sort of disappear, won't she?
Yes, you know how your father hates pets.
You always say it's Dad, but it's you who hates them, really. Anyway, I'm not getting rid of her.
But Harmony, you're like a wild animal in this house as it is. We can't have two.
She's not a wild animal. She's dead friendly and intelligent, not like you lot.
That's enough. The rabbit goes.
No!
Oh, Harmony, come back here.
Oh, my head. I wish they'd go. I wish I could trade them in. I wish... Wait a minute. I can trade them in. What do you think? Good idea. Yes, I knew you would.
Harmony, come downstairs this minute.
I'm coming!
Even my smelly family couldn't resist the power of the Queen's nose.
Harmony!
I'm coming!
I wish that my family were completely different. Do you think it'll work, Anita? I wonder what they'll be like.
It couldn't be any worse.
Horrible. I mean, they were horrible before, but now they're disgustingly horrible. Yes, you're right. I could wish them back to normal, but then I'll have wasted two wishes.
knows that monster I saw coming out of your house?
What monster?
The one with the bald head and tattoos.
Oh, her. Melody.
That's not your sister. Your sister's more like a Barbie doll.
Not anymore, she's not. Now they're all a bunch of disgusting slobs. It's been a nightmare. First off, Mum insisted I went shopping this morning.
Oh, lovely. Chris.
What a disaster.
Oh, Harmony, look. Oh, lovely.
Excuse me, madam.
Why, what you done?
I'm afraid it's against the law to eat something before you pay for it.
Oh, yeah, who says so?
Well, everyone.
Well, I'm not everyone, am I? I'm Mrs. Audrey Parker. No? A law unto myself, as you might say.
I'm afraid I shall have to call the police.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm afraid you won't. Come on, Harmony. Let's give old Snooty Boots a run for his money.
Then, later on, things got worse. Dad came back with his old motorbike and insisted on taking me for a ride.
King of the Road! Great day for biking!
Humiliation! My own dad bound over to keep the peace. Then old sis took me to a burger bar. Mistake number three.
Good lads, check it out.
Nightmare on Elm Street.
We've got a turn from the living dead.
Wait a minute. I'm going to give you a lesson on how to treat the opposite sex.
Why? Because you're not. Have you got a problem?
No, but you have. Oh. Me.
Yeah.
Listen, I don't talk to skin.
Before long, old sis had pulverised them.
Wow, all that just by wishing.
Yeah, now I don't know how to stop it.
Can I see them?
Come on then. But don't blame me if they eat you or something.
What are you laughing at, Midget? Perhaps you want to go through the door too.
What if only Uncle Ginger was here? Hello?
Harmony, it's me.
Uncle Ginger, how did you know I needed to speak to you?
I got the message. I think you've wasted a wish, haven't you?
Sort of, yes.
I can hear the results. Now, there is a limit, you know. Remember the rhyme?
No. Hang on. 10's the limit and there's the rub. 10 wishes.
Right. And beware of wishing for your heart's desire. If it's out of the frying pan,
then it's into the fire. It's telling me to be careful of what I want, isn't it?
Right. But I think you're going to have to use another wish to get things back to normal.
But I've got a rabbit and they might make me get rid of her.
Perhaps. But you have to make the wish and take the risk, don't you?
I suppose so.
I'm going to have to go now, Harmony. I'll be thinking of you. Ah!
I wish that my family would go back to how they were before.
Help! Help!
Oh, no. Something's gone wrong.
Come on. Help, Harmony, please. Please help me.
Let's see. I did everything right. Rubbed the Queen's nose on the coin and made the wish. Look, you guys, I really, really mean it. I want you back, Mum.
I love you.
Harmony. Tom, what are you doing?
Hi.
Back. Can you remember anything?
Daft as a brush.
Happier than the centipede and happy as a hyena. Hiya, Dad.
Harmony, if I were to visit your planet, what sort of life forms could I expect to find?
Good question. Highly intelligent life forms, the Harmonium vertebrate and the Damascus ignoramus.
Yes.
And the...
Yes. Now go and...
I'll go and feed my rabbit.
Oh, yes, your rabbit.
Yes.
What do you think, Arthur? Arthur?
What?
What do you think?
I'm sure you're about to tell me, my dear.
Perhaps you can keep the rabbit. If...
But she's got to get rid of it, you said!
If there are no more accidents, then perhaps you can keep her. Isn't that what we've decided, Arthur?
I'm sure we have, if you say so.
Oh, yes, cool!
Well, it's not fair. You told her she couldn't have any pets.
Thanks, Uncle Ginger.
She is beautiful, isn't she?
Yeah. Funny, that. How she was invisible one minute, and not the next.
Perhaps she didn't need to be invisible anymore. Your parents were ready to accept her. Everything must have a purpose. Even invisibility.
Harmony? Oh, how extraordinary.
What is?
Well, I was just going to ask you if you had a 50 pence piece for the stamp machine, and there you are, holding one. Oh, a little miracle, really. Here you are, 5 tens.
Now, you can't have this one.
Why on earth not? Come along.
No way, Ozai, this one's special.
Oh, Harmony, don't be so ridiculous. And don't pull that face at me.
I keep your distance, face. People have died by ignoring it.
Harmony, will you please stop all this nonsensical nonsense and give me that coin?
No!
Yes! Give it to me!
I wish I'd get this one back.
Silly girl.
Mom, this means war!
Harmony, don't be so silly! Stop it this minute. Oh, very well, take your silly coin and just wait till your father gets home. Oh!
No!
Sorry, the door was open. No.
I can see it. The nose, it's glinting. But how?
I'm Gregory,
Yes, you opened the blazing door, and that's why it's down there.
I'm sorry,
Let's see. I could make some sort of noose.
That's my tie.
Some sort of lasso. What do you think?
Is Melody in?
Yeah, she's in the kitchen sharpening her broomstick.
Hey, you
can't... Oh, yes, I can. You're Melody's new boyfriend, aren't you?
Well, I suppose I am, but look.
You're not such a nerd as the last three.
Harmony?
Hello, I'm...
Gregory! Yes! Got it!
I bought you some chocolates.
Thanks. What was your name?
Gregory.
Any more wishes?
Wasted one.
Better make the rest count, then. You want to wish for something you couldn't possibly have without the magic of the Queen's nose.
Yeah. Something useful. Something I couldn't normally afford.
Like a lion or a shark.
That pond's a bit small for a shark, wouldn't you say, Tom?
You could wish for a bigger one. The Melody might fall in and get eaten.
Oh, don't be such a prat. Anyway, she deserves fate worse than being eaten alive by a shark. No. What I wish for deserves serious thought. Something I couldn't otherwise have. I've got it!
What?
Yeah. Can I help you, young lady?
Yes, I'd like to look at a few of your best bikes.
The best, eh? Right. Well, how about this? Top of the range girls folding cycle. It's got 3-speed Sturmey Archer gears and it's as nice to ride as it is to fold and put in the boot of your dad's car.
Excellent.
Now, I want one with fat tyres, straight handlebars and a saddlebag for my rabbit.
Your rabbit?
Yeah, but she likes to get about a bit, you know, new places, new sights and new experiences.
Yeah. Well, how about this? Outsized TIG-welded frame, 15-speed index Shimano gears, cotterless chain set, alloy wheels and handlebar ends fitted as standard and cantilever brakes and, of course, fat tyres.
This is it. This is the bike. It's brilliant.
It's also very expensive.
How much?
£169.99.
I'll take it.
I think you'll find that 50 pence is not enough, young lady.
Wow, these are great!
Yes, don't scratch the paintwork.
I wish to have this bike.
50p just isn't enough.
Is there a problem, Simpson?
Yeah, this young lady, she wishes to purchase this bike, but she's
this
only
particular
got...
bike?
Yes, please.
Certainly, young lady.
She can't.
Shut up, Simpson. This bicycle is no ordinary bicycle. This bicycle is the 10,000th of this model to be made. And the manufacturer has said that the person to choose this bicycle shall be given it gratis.
What's gratis?
For free. It's a prize.
Wow, did you hear that, Harm?
It works. It really works, Tom. Can I have it now?
Well, we'll have to take a few photographs of you first for publicity purposes, and then tomorrow the local television people will want to do a piece on you.
I don't want to be on television.
Such modesty! Everyone wants to be on television.
I don't. Most of it's rubbish.
I like Much of the Day and Neighbours. Can she be on Neighbours?
No, she cannot be on Neighbours. Simpson, the camera.
By the way.
Perhaps when you come back tomorrow to collect your prize and meet the television people, you could, look a little different.
Testing. We will rock you.
I'll take them, thanks. It's all right.
Thank you very much. You're right, Dave.
What?
He can't hear you.
Great, we need a deaf sound man. Right, now, I'm going to be asking you some questions about how you feel about winning.
Why?
Well, because that's what people want to know.
Why?
But I ask the questions, won't it? I'll also be asking you about your family.
Why?
We couldn't give the spike to another child, could we? What about one of the lads here?
No, you couldn't. She's the one that won. I'll do the interview
no,
for you.
No, thanks very much. We might get you handing the bike over or something, right?
And I could say a few words.
No, you couldn't. Only the kid talks and me, right? How are we doing there? Ready? Okay, right. Turn over. Okay, recording. Welcome to Regional Roundup. I'm Bradley Smart, and tonight I've got one of the luckiest girls in the region with me, Harmony Parker. Hello, Harmony.
Hello.
It's brilliant.
It's perfect. It's the best bike in the world.
I still can't believe we just won it. I mean, it's a chance in a million.
Not when the power of the Queen's nose is with you.
Harmony, what time is the programme on?
I've already told you. 7:00.
What do you think I should wear?
What, to watch the television?
Yes, I've telephoned everyone I know to ask them to come in and watch it with us. Hello. Do you like to try some of these?
Oh,
no,
lovely.
How's your glass?
Thank
Angela,
you.
Empty. Oh, Arthur! Arthur, Angela's glass is empty.
Oh, how unusual.
Arthur, what time is it?
It's 1 minute later than when you last asked me, dear. It's 7:09.
Do you know, I'm so proud of her. Arthur, is the video set up?
Yes, dear, you've made me check it 3 times.
I may have some copies made as Christmas presents. Such a shame about your outfit, Harmony. And I hope you remembered to speak properly and not drop your H's.
Of course I didn't.
Arthur, what time is it now?
It's 7:08.
Shh, it's on! Oh.
And welcome to Regional Roundup. I'm Bradley Smart, and tonight I'm with one of the luckiest young ladies in the region, Harmony Parker. Hello, Harmony.
Hello.
Now, lucky Harmony won this splendid bicycle here in this very store by being the 10,000th customer. Not now. Tell me something about yourself and your family, Harmony. What's your father do?
He works in the city, in business. He's a
Sort of arranges things.
Sort of a Mr. Fix-It. Let's hope that if the bicycle should need it, Harm and his father can fix it one day.
No, the only thing he'd like to fix is the income tax man for good.
Really?
I'm ruined.
What about your mother?
She spends a lot of time in bed, fainting and getting migraines.
It must be very hard on your father.
Well, he jokes about it. He says he married Mum because she spends so much time in bed and she can't be out spending all his money.
Chronic invalid mocked by an uncaring Mr. Fix-It husband.
It's only a joke.
No, Harmony, it's a tragedy. Do you have brothers and sisters?
A sister, Melody. But I sometimes call her Stupid Sis. But
stupid? In what way stupid?
I'll forget about it.
It's all right. I understand. It's too painful to talk about. A sister with problems, a father who has difficulty relating to his family, an invalid mother. In short, a dysfunctional family. But for this young lady, today, this special day, is a dream come true. So before I hand back to you in the studio, let's take a look at Harmony and her new splendid bicycle. Take it away, Harmony.
Delightful.
Well, with Harmony around, we've certainly developed a sense of humour.
So glad to see you.
Yes, and you.
Stay here, young lady. You've got some explaining to do.
I can't bear it. I'll be a laughing stock.
Harmony, how could you?
Sort of all slipped out. I didn't mean it.
Liar, you did it on purpose.
Look what the neighbours have thought. Oh, the shame. Oh,
I will never be ashamed anyway.
You should have heard them. Being on and on at me. They sounded like...
Yep.
Uncle Ginger.
5 wishes gone. Dear, dear. You must be wondering whether all these wishes are worth it.
But they must be, mustn't they? Otherwise, why did you give me the coin? You wouldn't give me anything bad, would you?
Not bad. Difficult, perhaps. Real wishing is a power. So beware of what you want. Wishes and wisdom. Wish and wise are very close together. And what you wish for affects others. And some wishes are just like this. Catch it, Harmony.
I wish I could do that. Sorry. Think before you wish.
I'll be seeing you, Harmony. And in the meantime, you have a beautiful bike. Take care of it.
Watch me jump!
Trying to kill yourself?
No, just testing the suspension. Your turn now.
No way.
You're scared?
Terrified. So you really saw your Uncle Ginger again last night?
Yep.
That's amazing. What's he going to wish for next?
I don't know. I need to spend a bit of time thinking about it. Hang on.
What's that?
My 50 pence piece of... The Queen's nose, where is it?
Perhaps you dropped it.
No, I... Of course. It's in my old jeans.
Oh, Harmony!
are too revolting.
He threw them out. Where?
I put them in the dustbin. Darling, there was a hanky in one pocket.
And the other pocket?
Only one thing in that.
What?
A hole.
Gone! We could have dropped out anywhere. Looked everywhere. Oh, Anita, if only Uncle Ginger would appear, he'd know what to do. Oh, Tom.
We might find it.
Might not.
Maybe someone nicked it then.
If anyone has, I'll make sure they regret it.
Maybe it's a test.
Sort of test.
You know, ingenuity. The 50 pence piece loses itself. You have to use all your brain power to try and find it.
Maybe.
But we will find it. Follow me. Support.
Oh, thanks, Tom.
What are they all doing?
Looking for Harmony's 50 pence piece, I should imagine.
Ooh. But why are they? What's so special about it?
Perhaps it's because Uncle Ginger bought it for her. You know how she idolises him, just like a kid.
I wish she'd hurry up and find it. Makes me nervous having a whole posse of children in the garden.
Oh, I don't think she'll find it.
It's no good. It's not out here. I feel it's not.
A sixth sense, eh?
Oh, shut up. Now, everyone, we're moving into the house. A thorough search. I want the whole place turned over.
They're regrouping. They look as if they're getting ready to attack. What should we do?
Oh, well, they're only little kids. We'll just tell them to shove off.
Yes, no, no, you can't come in here. You're all to stay in the garden. Do you hear me? Do you understand? None of you is to come in here. No!
Sorry, we're on a mission.
We're acting under orders.
You don't you dare go in my room!
Which one's that?
The one with the white bedspread!
Cheese, her on first!
Could be worse. We've got the well-behaved kids in.
Shut up.
No. Sorry.
I cannot stand this a moment longer.
What's up with her?
She's having a nervous breakdown.
What do you think?
I think you ought to get arrested.
No fat in writing.
Sorry, Harm. The top came off and all the stuff came out. It was a bit of a pong anyway.
That's my best perfume!
Gregory bought that for me! I'm going to kill you!
What's all the fuss about? Perfume's only posh soap anyway. I've got to find my 50 pence piece, the Queen's nose.
I am utterly sick of that 50 pence piece. If you must know,
I spent it.
You what?
Are you deaf? I said I spent it.
What?
Well, I needed a scissoring pink lipstick urgently, and I found your stupid 50 pence piece. I put another one in your piggy bank the next day, so there's no problem.
No problem. Where did you spend it?
Well, at the post office.
Come on. Everyone out!
Harmony Parker. How can I help you?
I want to go through all the money in your till. There's just a chance you may have a coin that belongs to me.
Look, people come in here usually to spend money, not to take it away.
Yes, but this coin's special.
It's magic. Ow! Sorry.
It's a 50 pence piece.
Well, I can't clear the till out just to find a 50 pence piece for you, can I?
It's got sentimental value. My favourite uncle gave it to me, and he's gone into the darkest jungles of the world, and I may never see him again. He gave me this coin and told me to guard it with my life and never to let it out of my sight. And if I've lost this coin, I may have to hold my breath and fall down and die. And you'll go to prison for child murdering.
All right, I'll see what I can do.
See how you know which is your coin.
I'll know, all right? Yes! That's it! That's the one!
How do you know they're all the same?
I just know. Thanks a lot.
Just a minute.
What?
You owe me 50 pence.
Oh, Tom, pay the lady.
Thank you.
This is my pocket money. You owe me.
Tom, you got it back. What's the problem?
Say she's the problem. How dare she? How dare that ferret-faced monster take my magic coin?
She didn't know how important it was. How could she?
She still took it, didn't she?
Yeah, but you got it back.
Oh, no thanks to her, I didn't. You just don't see, do you? She isn't going to get away with this. It's a pointer honour. The honour of the Queen's nose demands revenge.
Sounds more like you wanting to get your own back.
That too.
So what are you going to do?
Boils on her bottom. Attacked by killer spiders in the bathroom. Caterpillars in her tights.
That over the top, isn't it? You're serious, aren't you?
Deadly serious.
Sometimes you're a bit scary. I have to go home for tea.
Okay.
I'll bring my bike and my football round. Maybe it'll have calmed down a bit by then.
Don't bet on it. I'll leave it up to you and the power of the Queen's nose. I wish that something disgustingly horrible would happen to that twit that I'm numbered with his sister.
Darling, come along. You come with me.
Harmony, go put the kettle on.
Come along, darling. We'll have a nice cup of tea.
I don't want a nice cup of tea.
But of course you do. It'll make you feel better.
No, it won't.
Well, it'll make me feel better.
Boy, you should see her, Anita. She looks like the Yeti. Uncle Ginger would say I was stupid.
I know she took the coin and everything, but I shouldn't have wished for something horrible to happen to her.
Trouble is, if I get too sympathetic, they'll get all suspicious that I had something to do with it.
Better be pretty drastic to drag me back from work. Giddy aunt.
That's one hairy sister you've got back there. Did you actually ask for that to happen?
No, just for something horrible. You know, she might even be more interesting in her new hairy state. Most animals are more interesting than people anyway.
She looked pretty miserable to me.
She'll get used to it.
She won't stay like that, will she?
Who knows?
But that's horrible. Don't you care?
You're not going to get all soft on me, are you? I hate it when you're like that.
But she is your sister.
Oh, that's not my fault. I didn't exactly choose her, did I?
But you should be doing something to try and get her back to normal.
Don't tell me what I ought to be doing. I am sorry it happened.
You don't show it much.
Oh, I'm supposed to get all sobby, am I? Get lost, Tom.
And darling, soon be back to normal. It's just a nasty aberration. Probably just sent to try me.
Keep still, cut you. And I still think we should call the doctor.
No! See if this works first. It had better. Gregory's coming round later. I couldn't...
Don't worry, darling. You'll be fine.
Oh, I think I'm going to be sick. I bet it was her.
Who?
Harmony. Who else? I smell a rat behind this, and it's my sister.
How could Harmony have done this?
Well, I don't know, do I? But she's capable of anything.
Ah! Ah, wait!
What?
Well, I meant that it was rotten what happened to your sister. I bet your Uncle Ginger would think so too. If it happens again, what you ought to do is...
Maybe it won't, and don't ever tell me what I ought to do.
But you're always telling me what to do.
That's because you're stupid.
So you keep telling me. But not anymore!
Tom! Tom, come back! I didn't mean it.
Doesn't this look good? Delicious. I'll take some to the girls. There you are, Harmony. I'll try and eat it all this time. One for you, Melody. Well, isn't this fun?
Stop doing that.
What?
Looking at me.
Yes, you've hurt her feelings quite enough for one day.
Very curious from a biological point of view.
Well, get on with your supper from an eating point of view.
Sorry. Anyway, it's all gone now, and it probably won't come back again.
No, so let's stop talking about it, shall we?
Good idea. I mean, it must have been horrible. I mean, I for one am glad it's all gone, all that horrible fluff. Imagine if the papers had heard. Photographed.
Oh dear. Wait, so not Harmony. I do wish you'd try and be a little more sensitive.
Yes, you have an unerring knack of saying precisely the wrong thing every time you open your mouth.
Uncle Ginger didn't think so. He was always interested in me.
Yes, well, he doesn't have to live with you all the time, does he?
You're always blaming me. You're acting as if it was my fault stupid sis got all that face buzz.
Funnily enough, she thinks it was.
Does she? Excuse me, I'm finished. Exceeding the anger of the whole world.
So, anything exciting happened today?
What do you mean? What have you heard?
Nothing. I was just asking.
Are you sure?
Yes.
No one said anything about me, about my face or my arms.
No? Why?
Oh, no reason. Well, it's just that people talk.
I know. That's what I was doing. Is everything all right?
Yes, of course. Why? Why don't I look all right? Can you see anything?
No.
It was just like a bad dream, that's all.
Yeah. What was?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
That's all right, then.
You can kiss me if you like.
Perhaps we shouldn't have shaved her, you know. It seems to be growing back at twice the rate.
It's all right, Gregory. It's just a little problem she's inherited from her father's side of the family.
You mean it's happened before?
Only once. And we gave her such a good shave.
Shave?
Yes. I think it might start some sort of new fashion. What do you think? Gregory, say something.
I don't...
Another wish used up.
Tom was right, though. And what he said about Uncle Ginger.
I wish that Melody would go back to her normal, horrible... I mean, normal self. Without all that fuzz growing on her. Ever again. Please? Is she right? No more problems. Please.
Only 3 wishes left. I've wasted so many.
So, my next wish. What do I really want? Or maybe I should turn it around and say, what don't I want? Then wish for that.
Not to go to school. That'll be my next wish. To have the whole term off.
Yes. I wish that I don't have to go to school for the next term.
Great!
No school, I can't wait to tell Anita. Mum! Melody, I've lost Anita! Have you seen my rabbit? She's ginger and white and she's escaped.
No, love, sorry.
She might be invisible.
Then I definitely haven't seen her.
Have you seen a rabbit?
Sorry.
been having bad dreams.
I know. You've been shouting out.
What did I shout?
Well, it sounded like the Queen knows. But I don't know what the Queen is supposed to know. Probably you don't either.
How badly am I hurt?
Quite badly. Got a broken leg. And quite a lot of cuts and bruises. You'll mend quicker than you imagine.
What about school?
No school for you this term.
Power of the Queen's nose.
Hmm? The Queen knows what?
Nothing.
Put some chocolates. And here's the stuff that was in your pockets when you had the accident. Your famous 50 pence piece. Time for Harmony's medication. Oh, I'll just be over there, darling. Excuse me.
You're lucky to have such a family.
Your mum and dad have been taking it in turns to sit with you.
Hi. How are you feeling?
All right. A bit strange.
Well?
Well, what?
Well, nothing, just, well. I brought you something.
Not a ton of grapes.
No. Anita.
Anita! How? I mean, when?
Next door telephoned. They found her in their garden. She'd eaten all their lettuce and sweet peas. I don't think they were too happy.
She looks brilliant.
I've been feeding her up. She likes parsley and apples.
Yep, she's got sophisticated tastes. Thanks, Melody. It's all right. How come you've been looking after her? You hate me. Ah, you were getting worried about your dear little sister.
Don't push your luck, Harmony. You're in a very vulnerable position in that bed.
I am grateful. It'd be good if I could do something for you. What would you like if someone said you could have anything in the whole world? What would you ask for?
To go to America. It's not likely to happen, though.
No.
Oh, you're tired. They said you've got to sleep a lot. I'll see you soon.
You're a problem and an opportunity. Two wishes left. One's already spoken for.
Right.
So, only one wish left for me.
You'll be late for school. It's from my cousin Jessica. I wonder why she's written to you.
Dear Melody, your mother always says in her letters how you'd love to come to the States. So, please find enclosed a return ticket for a 2-week trip.
What?
We look forward to having you stay with us.
Melody!
You're going to America! Yeah. Oh.
It's your turn, isn't it? Have fun.
To bed! Oh. Only a bit of recreation for the patients. Mental relaxation, AIDS recovery. I read that somewhere.
Where on earth did you get this leg from? It was sort of lying about. It was in the cupboard, as well you know. And you went in and took it!
Sorry, it was a sort of red mist came over us.
Oh, delayed concussion.
Must be from the accident.
A blow to the head. If I told the doctor about this, there'd be another accident. And an even bigger blow to the head.
Charming. I thought you were meant to make people better, not beat them up.
Sometimes we do both. It's the red mist. Comes over us. Just get back to bed. Doctor will be furious.
Ah, yes. Harmony Parker. The hospital disaster.
If I win, I get all the sweets your family brings in. And your compass?
Yes, and if I win, I get your Blur t-shirt. Deal?
Deal.
Where is she?
She was here. I don't know.
I thought I gave you specific instructions that she was not to leave the ward.
You did, Doctor, but she was here a minute ago.
And now she is not. Find her, staff! Moving on.
After three. One,
two,
three, go!
Oh, you cheat! Yes!
Safety of patients, staff, and hospital equipment. What have you got to say for yourselves?
Well, if you oiled the axles of these wheelchairs, they'd go a lot faster.
Axles? She tells me to oil the axles. Don't you realize how dangerous it was? Apart from everybody else, you put your own life in danger. You've had a very bad accident, you're lucky to be alive, and now you start risking your life again just for the fun of it.
Not just for the fun of it. I had to win this t-shirt. Cool, isn't it?
Go on, both of you. Get out. I want Harmony Parker out today.
It's a bit soon, Doctor.
It can't be soon enough. Give her the wheelchair. Give her everything she wants. Whatever she wants, give it to her. Just get her out.
Bye, Harmony!
Bye, Nurse. Thank you so much for everything.
I can't believe I'm letting you go so soon.
Oh, yeah, the doctor said I had this amazing body that healed in double, triple time. And I'd done so well, and I was so well behaved. And there was no point in keeping me in. And they've given me the wheelchair.
You don't mind about me going to America?
No, it's great. It's funny. It happened just after you asked me what I wanted.
Yeah.
What's for supper?
Anything you want.
Chips, deep pan pizza, egg on toast, chicken nuggets, beans, mushy peas, and more chips, and a large cup, please. Treacle tart, custard, biscuits, and ice cream. Thanks, Mum.
Oh. Well, you certainly got your appetite back with a vengeance.
Can we go now, please?
Now, take care. Don't talk to any strangers. Make sure you've got your passport and your money.
Mum, you've told me 1,000 times.
We'll call you from the airport.
Goodbye, sis.
Bye, honey.
No, I'm sorry, I can't come to the airport. Have a brilliant time and thanks for looking after Anita.
I can't, Tom. I can't.
Come on, you can do it. I know you can. Yes, I knew you could do it.
So did I. I have been doing my own walking since I was little.
How does it feel?
A bit funny. Didn't realise I was so tall.
It seems to have changed things.
What's changed what?
The accident. Since then, you've been getting on better with your family.
Oh, they're all right.
Oh, come on. Meredith going to America. It was you, wasn't it?
No.
It was the power of the Queen's nose.
Cool. I'd better go. See you tomorrow. After school. By the way, how many wishes are left?
Just the one.
Thank you.
my last wish. It's my birthday soon. What do I want more than anything in the world? I know. Who is it?
It's your dad. So this is where you spend all your time, is it? Looks like it could do with a bit of fixing up.
Thanks, Dad. But I've got used to it like this.
Got something for you. Out here.
For me?
For when you're back to your old fighting self. It's the same colour.
Thanks.
I was wondering.
What?
Well, I was wondering if I might give it a try, you know, seeing as you're indisposed just now.
Be my guest.
Up, and away!
Arthur, it's a burglar.
What?
Wake up! Arthur, it's a burglar trying to sound like Harmony!
No, it's Harmony trying to sound like Harmony.
Mum, something's wrong.
With what?
Not what, whom, Uncle Ginger.
Something's wrong with Ginger when he's 3,000 miles away.
I know, but I felt it.
Oh, so you wake us up, but... Oh, Harmony, it's 2:30. Go back to bed. We'll talk about it in the morning.
Why are we too late, then? We have to do something now!
Harmony! We can't go to India at 2:30 in the morning. They'll all be in bed.
Well, even if something was wrong, there really isn't anything we can do now. Try and get some sleep, Harmony. Go on.
All right, I'm going. Don't say I didn't warn you.
Get
to the point, will you?
Well, I was wondering if you could use your last wish to sort of make it so I could play football with Gary Rabbit. The only way that's going to happen is by magic.
You must be bonkers. Use up my last wish on that. Anyway, I want that wish for my birthday.
I've never asked you for anything before. Well, nothing big.
Tom, no way am I going to use up my very last wish on you playing football with Gary Mabbott.
Why not? You used to put wish on your sister and you hated her. And I'm meant to be your friend.
All right, I suppose that one thing I've learned from all this wishing is that when you start being selfish, something goes wrong. Maybe I should use it for you. Then, if there's any bad luck about it, you'll be the one clobbered by it.
You'll do it then. Please.
All right.
Yes. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Yes.
Shame about the puppy there.
Yes, yes, as soon as you know. Thank you.
I may be late this evening. What is it? What's the matter?
That was the British Embassy. It's Ginger. He's in a hospital in the mountains. He was found in a village with a very bad fever. They say he's very ill and...
And what?
He's very ill. And as far as they know, we should be prepared for... Oh, Arthur.
He might die, that's what they mean.
They said they'll fax us as soon as there's any news.
Still 101. Still 103 last night. It's going down.
Too slowly. He's too weak to sustain this condition for much longer. The fever should have reached some sort of crisis by now, either way.
Harp! He hasn't rung yet!
Who?
Gary Mabbott, of course! I've been sitting by the phone for ages! Hey, you might even come round and say, come on, Tom, get your boots on. We're going to play some mean footy. What then? Do you think he'll send a posh car round to take me to the match?
No, he won't.
You didn't make the wish, did you?
No.
You promised.
Sorry, Tom, I can't.
I hardly ever ask you for anything.
It's not because I want the wish for myself. It's Uncle Ginger. He's seriously ill. So I thought I'd use my last wish to try and make him better.
Do you think that'll work?
Most of the wishes have just made life more difficult. And this is life and death, so I don't want to mess it up.
So take the risk. Forget about the football match and save your Uncle Ginger.
What do you think, Anita? That settles it. I'll do it. I am sorry, Tom. Really.
You win some, you lose some. Thing is, I'd like to win... just once.
Uncle Ginger? The most important wish I've made. So please let it happen properly. I wish that Uncle Ginger gets better and comes home to us. Please. Please.
Harmony? Darling, I need some shopping. Will you go to the market for me?
Okay, I'm coming.
Thank you.
harmony. There's someone in the living room, home again and longing to see you.
Yes, Uncle Ginger! I knew it would work! I knew he'd be back!
Boo!
Melody, I never thought I'd say this, but I quite missed you.
Sort of missed you too. It's like there was something missing. You know, like having
a wart removed.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Listen, Mum told me about Ginger. I'm sure.
I'm sure too. It's going to be all right. It's got to be.
Yeah.
Did you have a good time?
Oh, brilliant. And I met this boy.
Oh, things to do. Tell me later.
Hank.
Hank?
Good afternoon.
It's about that charity football match you're organising. Do you have any team places left? Great. Yeah, there'll be three of us. Yeah, if one can be in goal. Yeah, it is definite. And her name is...
But I'm useless! And I just make a complete prat of myself!
So what else is new? Look, you've got to do it, because I've put your name down and mine.
Yours? But you're still hobbling around in a crutch.
So? I'm still twice the player you are.
I wouldn't mind if I was going to meet Gary Mabbutt, but I'm not. I'm just going to end up with my leg kicked in.
Look, you better turn up for that match, or you'll regret it forever.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I said so, that's why. And that's good enough that you've got 3 days to get some decent training in. That's it. Up. Not too high. Come on, faster!
43. 44.
Keep the ball closer to your feet. More control.
65. 66.
That's better. Keep your eye on the ball. Good. Yes!
89. 100.
Yes!
Look, you said you could definitely provide three players. So where's the other one?
I don't know. He'll be here. He promised.
Fat chance. We start in 5 minutes. And you can only just about hobble. How'd you expect a playing goal like that?
Just watch me, all right?
We haven't got a hope in Blue Moses of winning. Have you seen the yellows? The team captain's like a gorilla.
Not nearly as brainy, though.
You what?
Nothing.
Ready? One of our teams still to arrive.
Well, if he's anything like the rest of you, I shouldn't bother waiting. He'll be flattened by half-time. Look, let's start, and if your other player turns up, he can join in.
OK. Well, come on, team.
My dear, spectators are not allowed to hit the opposition team.
Wasn't much good, was it?
Why didn't Gary Mabbutt turn up? That's what I want to know.
Gary Mabbutt? I suppose he was the other player, was he?
Yes, that's right.
Oh, sure. Look, listen, if Gary Mabbutt turned up here, I'll give you a fiver.
Somebody taking my name in vain? You must be Harmony.
Yes, and Tom. And this is Tom.
Hello, Tom. Pleased to meet you. Not the talkative type, eh?
No.
But you're Gary Mabbutt.
And you're short of a fiver.
I'll take American Express.
Okay, Tom, we'll plan our tactics. Right, here's what we do.
Wonderful, no, Arthur.
The game was terrific, and you were magnificent, my dear. Well, Harmony, what should we do? Go out and celebrate your great victory?
No. I think I'll just go home.
I know how she feels. I'm afraid it's not going to be much of a birthday for her without Ginger.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Harmony. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, sweetheart.
Thanks.
Here's my present for you. It's a picture of me with Gary Mabbutt.
Great. I'll open it later, I think.
Oh, cheer up, darling. Make a wish.
Imagine if he'd just arrive. If he'd just ring.
You.
Happy birthday. I bought you some chocolates. Here. Is Melody in?
Yeah. Suppose you better come in, Grogsy.
Thanks.
I wouldn't get your hopes up, though. She's got this yank she's in love with. He weighs 15 stone and hates English people.
He's a one-year angler, isn't he, eh? He reckons I've got a natural flair for magic. I said to him, I wish I could wish myself a win on the lottery.
Hang on, you've spoken to him.
Squasher. For you, happy birthday. Come on, let's take her for a walk.
I followed those huge icy footprints. And suddenly there he was.
Really? And then what?
He looked at me, and I looked at him.
And then what?
He walked away.
You let the Yeti walk away from you?
I'd seen him, I'd met him, it was enough.
But you didn't take any photographs or anything. People might not believe you.
Do you believe me?
Yes.
That's enough for me. I'm going to persuade you all to come with me on my next trip.
Wow.
I think, with a little bit of cajoling, your father can be persuaded to take a few months off work. In fact, I know he will.
Wow. Where would we go?
Nepal. I've always wanted to meet a snow leopard. What about all those wishing adventures, eh?
A bit hairy, some of them.
You know what you have to do now, don't you?
Yes, I think I do.
Don't think about it, just do it.
Snow leopard make
a kind of low, thoughtful noise, a kind of